Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum everyone. Welcome to the first Safina QA video. MashaAllah, you all sent a number of good questions, and we're going to get to most of them as much as possible. But first, I want to talk about how we're supposed to learn. How are we supposed to gain knowledge? How are we supposed to go about getting our answers, our questions answered? Now, one of the things that it's sort of hard for people to realize that not every question in Islam is black and white. All right? Not every question in Islam is found in detail that really you just have a list of permissible things and a list of forbidden things. That's not how the deen works. As human beings are far more complex than to have simply a manual that covers every single aspect of their lives. Right? And the Quran tells us, مَا فَرَّطْنَا فِي الْكِتَابِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. We haven't left anything out. And that, so how do we reconcile the two? Okay? The answer is the Quran gives us general instructions to go by that will get our gray answers, our gray questions answered. So consider this ayah. فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. This is a very heavy ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ask those who know if you don't know. Right? Now, one of the things that the ulama do is they don't always look at what the Quran says, they also look at what the Quran doesn't say. And in this case, what the Quran doesn't say is, if you don't know, open the Quran and look. Because the Quran is not claiming to be this type of manual that has all the details in it. Okay? Also, if we open it and look, we might misunderstand. So human beings need other human beings. Because we're so complex, we need other human beings. And this is why knowledge should never be separated from companionship. Right? Knowledge should never be separated from human beings. We shouldn't ever try to simply think that there is going to be everything in the text. Another thing, this ayah also doesn't say, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الْعِلْمِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. The ayah doesn't say, if you don't know, ask people of knowledge. It says people of dhikr, because the word dhikr, it implies two things. Number one, it implies knowledge, because knowledge of the deen is remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jalla. And dhikr in the sense of people constantly repeating, seeking knowledge, constantly studying, all right, repeating the same questions over and over until they become experts at them, okay, the same sciences. But dhikr also implies that they are people of ibadah, they're people of worship, they're people who take the remembrance of Allah seriously, and the chief moment of remembrance of Allah, what is it? Someone said, what is the best dhikr? Someone said, la ilaha illallah. Right? Another said, subhanallah, bihamdi, subhanallah, al-azim. Yet another, Umar ibn Khattab came, he said, it is remembering Allah at the moment you feel like committing a sin. Remembering Allah by pulling back from that temptation. All right. So, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ. Ask the people of dhikr, meaning the people of knowledge and piety. They act upon their knowledge. Allah says about them, كُونُوا مَعَ الصَّادِقِينَ. Be with them. Keep their company. Because any gray issue, all right, any gray issue, their lives, how they live their lives, okay, will show you whether or not they do this thing or they don't do this thing. Okay, and a lot of our knowledge is do this and don't do this. Well, what about the gray areas? The Prophet talked about it. He said in two things. Halal is clear, haram is clear. Between them are gray matters. لا يعلمهن كثير من الناس. Not many people know the gray matters. Okay, another thing he said. إن الله فرض فرائض وحد حدودا وسكت عن أشياء رحمة لكم غير نسيان. Which means Allah has obligated certain things. He has prohibited, set certain limits. And then he's remained silent about certain matters out of mercy to you, right? Not out of forgetfulness. So everything in this deen everything we need is in the Quran, and in this case, it's in the general. So you're going to come upon questions, and there are a lot of these hot button questions. Is it haram or halal? And there's a lot of discussion. A lot of times, your answer is going to be, what are the salihin? What are the pious and the righteous of your time doing? All right? How do they interact with it? You know, questions going to come up about music. Right, and there's fatawa on both sides. Of course, there's the majority. There is a majority in that question. All right, about meats. Okay, there's fatawa, and people. It's sad to see are always confused. Right, they're always confused when there are opposing fatwas on matters. Right, but always look back at what the Quran says. All right, be with the righteous. The Prophet himself, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this is not that he needs to be with people. He can be alone. But just to teach us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him in Surah Al-Kahf, وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاتِ وَالْعَشِيِّ يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَهُ. Be patient with those seeking Allah Azza wa Jalla's countenance morning and evening. And why does Allah say to be patient? Because sometimes you don't have anything in common with them. If you go out there and you go to your local masjid and you look for who has the signs of piety, right? Who we can only judge by externals, right? But who has the signs of piety and at the same time makes me feel when I'm in their company that I'm drawing near to Allah, my heart is opening up. And what is the sign of the heart opening up? The sign is that we don't seek dunya anymore. We're no longer interested in dunya. As the Prophet ﷺ said, you lose interest in worldly affairs and you start desiring to prepare for your otherworldly affairs. Okay, so that's a sign that your heart is opening up, your iman is increasing when you keep their company, their words are matching the Quran and the Sunnah. Now one of the things you realize is that you might not have a lot in common with them, right? What does Allah say? Be patient, stick with them, right? Learn to have more in common, because if they're the ones whose deen you can rely upon, and you want to go to the Akhirah, right, with those people, okay? You want to go to the Yawm al-Qiyamah with those people, be patient with them. It's worth the effort. It's worth the effort to say, you know, let me look out. Let me go to my masjid, and the masajid are the houses of Allah. And in the houses of Allah will be the guests of Allah, Azza wa Jal. Right? And masajid, whoever's in the masjid, he should be honored. He's invited. Right? Whenever you're in the masjid, you should say to yourself, Allah invited me, because Allah called it His house. No one enters His house without His will. Right? Anyone in a masjid, he's upon divine invitation. Okay? So the people who are constantly being invited, namely the people who are always in the masajid, right? These are the people most likely, they're going to be Ahlullah, the people who are people of taqwa. Right? So you want to be in their company, you want to have sabr. If you don't have much in common, still, you know, it's worth it for you. Right? Imagine, yeah, and if you had a boss, you don't have anything in common. But by keeping his company, you're going to get promoted. Aren't you going to keep his company? Of course you are, right? You have a father-in-law or a brother-in-law or a future son-in-law, daughter-in-law, what have you, mother-in-law. Maybe you don't have much in common with them, but right, you want something from them, right? You know, you want to marry their daughter, or they want you want the you're going to be related in some way, right? So you're going to keep their company. You're going to make it happen. You're going to make sure that relationship works because you need something. Likewise, we can never feel that all we need is the Quran, all right, Sahih Bukhari, couple websites, and that's all I need. I don't need to deal with people. It's not going to work. Right? It's not going to work. So the manhaj here, again, the manhaj, I'm going to, inshallah, be answering questions. We'll probably try to give you both sides and then also try to give you a type of nasiha. Right, so what we've seen work by the practice of the pious. So, but then again, at the same time, keep in mind the principle of the Prophet, peace be upon him, be with the righteous. Al-mar'u ala dini khalilih. A person is on the religion of his friend. Right, a person is on the religion of his friend. Right, فَلْيَنْظُرْ إِلَى مَنْ يُخَالِدْ. So, take a look at whose company you keep, because that's your religion. Jazakum Allah khairan. The second Safina QA video is going to be on a serious topic, namely belief in God, why we believe in Allah Azza wa Jal, and in specific, why we believe in Islam. Jazakum Allah khairan. We'll see you then. Assalamu alaikum.
This has been a Safina Society production.